channel. So today's video is going to be a very requested video, and it's about how to plan your revision over the Easter holidays. So I don't know about you, but I broke up yesterday on the 29th of March. Yes, 29th of March. It's currently the 30th of March, a Friday, and I am off until the 16th of April. So this is really the time for me that I'm going to start serious revision. I'm at A2, so my exams are a month later than GCSE and AS, hence why this is the start of my serious revision, whereas usually at AS and at GCSE I was revising a little bit earlier, but honestly this year I just have not had the time, like, have not had time to revise, like, at all since mocks. So here we are, I have 2 weeks off, and you're thinking, how do you plan your revision? How am I going to fit everything in? First tip: you're not going to get everything done that you want to get done. I know this sounds like a really negative thing to start this video off saying, but everybody always makes a plan for Easter revision, and literally, let me tell you, there will be about one person in every 100,000 people that actually gets done everything they want to do. So don't feel disheartened and don't feel discouraged. You still have term time and you still have study leave, hopefully, or you still have time before exams to finish everything that you need to finish. But Easter is a really, really good time to just get started and try and get through as much as you physically can. So first thing you need to do when you are revising is you need to sit down and you need to write a list of everything you need to cover. So I have, for A2, compiled a checklist, and on this checklist is everything that I would like to do before exams. So for example, for the Tempest, I would like to reannotate the Tempest again, but with extra focus on language, because that's what the exam is focused on. I'd like to do some A3 mind maps on different critical perspectives and readings of the Tempest, so like Marxist, feminist, because we have to write an essay on that. I'd also like to do Quizlet cards about the play in performance, because we have to write an essay on that mixed in with critical perspectives. I'd like to do a couple of past paper questions, and I'd also like to re-watch The Tempest 2 times just to make sure that I know the play well. So for each text that I do for English, for each paper that I have for languages, I've written a list. And it's not the most detailed list, like it's not like every day you need to do this, but I'm going to stick this up on my wall, and I'm going to aim to get as much of this done as is physically possible by the end of Easter. I will not get all of this done, I won't, but having the list will help me understand what I need to do, how I need to go about everything. And also, if you make a revision timetable, then each day you can decide to do a different thing depending on what your mood is. So for example, if I've put down that I'm doing paper 3 Spanish revision, I could either revise some of the speaking cards, learn my presentation for my research project, practice my research project, debate topics, anything like that. I'm not limited to one thing per day. And also, you don't know how much time all of these things are going to take, so by having a list, you give yourself that flexibility to do different things on different days depending on how much time you've got. So once you have got a list and you have established everything that you need to do, and that can be as detailed or as vague as you feel is necessary for you, then you need to go through your Easter holidays and black out any times that you are busy. So for example, I blacked out today because I went out clubbing last night, so I'm not particularly in the mood to be revising. And also, I have lots of YouTube videos that I need to film, I have forms that I need to send off to Oxford, I have just endless admin-y things to do, like student finance, whatever. So I blacked out today as an admin day, and I blacked out yesterday afternoon as a just to sleep, because I was so tired. So today, on my timetable, isn't even a day. And then I have a wedding next week, I have Big Beauty Day out, so those days are blacked off too. And I should also hopefully be going to see my little brownies on brownie holiday, going to visit them for the day in Easter as well, so that day is blacked out as well. So you need to make sure that you've blacked out the times that you know you definitely can't do, whether it's you're going to the theatre in the evening, whether you've got to have a whole day off, whatever, but just make sure you do that first, because then you can fit your revision around that. As you can see on my timetable, all of that day is blacked out, and 2 days are blacked out, one for Big Beauty Day out, one for the wedding, and one for the morning coming back from the wedding, but the rest of it is filled. Yay! I've already done a video on how to make a revision timetable, so there's not really much point in me going through that again, but just to sum up, I have different colours for each paper that I take, so that's like German paper 3, Spanish paper 3, Tempest, Chaucer, Farewell to Arms, Gatsby, like they all have different colours. And down the side here I just have hours, so I like to start revising at 7 in the morning usually, or like 7:30, because I like to finish at around 7 p.m. so I like to have the evenings to myself. But if you're a morning person, do the same as me. If you're an evening person, you might want to start at 11 and finish at 11. If you like to have a morning session and then have the middle of the day off and then have the afternoon to work again, defo go for it. I'm not here to tell you how many hours you should be doing. That is up to you. It's up to how many exams you've got. It's up to how much work you've done so far this year. But what I'm saying is make sure that your timetable is tailored to you and to no one else. For me personally, I work best in either 2 or 3 hour slots and then an hour break. So for this Easter holiday, I have done 2 hours in the morning, then an hour off, then 3 hours, then an hour off, then 2 hours, and then at the bottom I've just put vocab and grammar because I need to do that in the evening at some point. But that is a more of like a wind down activity, like I don't find it particularly strenuous, but it's a necessary evil. But you might work best in 55 minute slots with a 5 minute break, 25 minute slots with a 5 minute break. You might work best for like 6 hours at a time and then the rest of the day off. You know, you've got to figure out what works for you. Personally, I'm a 2 or 3 hour block sort of gal. I can concentrate for about 3 hours and then I need a break. And I really hate having like little 5 minute breaks. I would rather just blitz it and then have proper hour break where I can go and watch an episode of Friends and eat some food. But that's personal to me. But you need to figure out exactly how your brain best works. Easter is a really good time to do that. If you're worried and you don't want to plan out your day hour by hour, that is totally okay. You could do sessions. So you could do a morning session, I need to do this. In the afternoon session, I need to do that. In the evening session, I need to do that. For me personally, that doesn't work just because I get like behind really easily. But I like to plan out my day like to the T. So I've got from 7 to 8 I'm doing German, from 8 to 9 I'm doing German, from 10 to 11 I'm doing Unseen American Lit, then I'm doing Gatsby, then I'm doing Farewell to Arms, and I've got another break. Like I have to have it like that just because that's how my brain works, that's how I revise best. But you need to figure that out for yourself. I can't help you there because everybody is different. So once you have done that, you also need to make sure that you have everything you need. So make sure that you've brought everything home from school that you need. Make sure that all of your books are in the right order. Organise all your folders so that when you come to revise, you're not rummaging around. And make sure that you've done all your homework. Like, do your homework before you start revising, because at the end of the day, homework needs to get done. Revision also needs to get done, but it's not compulsory. So do your homework for the first couple of days, then revise. I personally have got no homework. I've done it all this week, so I am free to just revise without having to worry about homework. But if you have a lot of homework, do try and do it before you start revision if you can, because it will just lift that weight off your shoulders. Another thing I would definitely suggest doing is timetabling time for you to do something that you enjoy in Easter. Please, 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 please do not start revising on this Saturday that I'm uploading this video and revise Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Please don't do that. I cannot tell you how bad that will be for you, because you are going to have to go back to school after Easter and you are going to be shattered. And by the time you get to exams, you are just going to want to be done with them and you won't revise close to the time. So make sure, please, that you are doing something else this Easter that is not revision. I personally am going to a wedding and I'm going to Big Beauty Day Out. So that is me, like, got some plans. Obviously, I'm not saying go out every day because you need to be revising, but make sure you've got something to look forward to. I'll probably go out in the evening to the cinema with my mom a couple of times. I'll probably go see my friends at Costa, go to the shops. You know, like, just keep yourself busy, moving, out and about, and don't, for God's sake, don't lock yourself in your room for the whole of Easter, because you will go insane. Like, literally will go insane. My final tip for Easter revision, turn off your phone, okay? Like, I am telling you now, this Easter break is gonna be, especially if you're doing GCSE, the like key break for you in terms of revision. So when you get up in the morning, check your phone, then turn it off until you have done everything that you said you were going to do that day. So I will get up at 6:50 because that's the time I get up for school, so I don't mind getting up that time because I'm used to getting up that time. I'll check my phone, I'll have some breakfast, I'll just mooch around till about 7:30, then I'll start, and then I won't check my phone even when I have my breaks, I don't turn my phone back on. Not until 7 p.m. when I've done everything that I've told myself I was going to do. I do not check my phone. In the evening, go crazy. But don't check your phone until you've done everything that you need to do. And I promise you, your revision will be 10 times more productive. When you have a break and you go on your phone, your brain gets fogged up with social media, gets fogged up with everything that's going on in the world. If you just have a quick check in the morning, or maybe even don't check it in the morning, send your Snapchat streaks and turn your phone off, your brain is fresh, ready to go, and then in the evening, when your brain's a bit foggy from all the information, then it won't really matter if you're on social media because you want to go to sleep and your brain's all foggy anyway, if that makes any sense. But yeah, social media is your biggest enemy. I'm not saying delete it, like you don't have to delete your social media, but just know when to stop using them and know that they're not exactly going to help you with your exams. My final tip would definitely be, each day, don't just say I'm going to revise history, don't just say I'm going to revise politics, don't just say I'm going to revise maths. What part of maths are you going to be revising? What topic? What are you going to be doing? In the morning, when you look at your exam timetable, say for example, if I'm looking at this and I'm like, okay, on the 13th of April, I've got 2 hours of German, 3 hours of English, another 2 hours of German, and some vocab. Great, but like, what am I going to be doing? So I might be like, right, in the morning, I want to learn my RP presentation, I want to practice some frequently like asked questions, and then for English, I've put Unseen American Literature, Gatsby and A Farewell to Arms. So for Unseen American Literature, I might want to do a practice question. For Gatsby, I might want to go over key quotes. For Farewell to Arms, I might want to make a Quizlet. And then in the afternoon, I've put that I'm doing German literature. So am I going to reread some of the book? Am I going to do you see what I mean? Like, make sure you don't just have German literature. Like, what are you going to be doing within that bracket? Because that will make your revision so much more focused. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was useful. Please don't worry, you still have time. Easter is such a good time for you to get started, and I know that the last thing you want to be doing is spending 2 weeks revising. Trust me, I am with you, and I am dreading starting revising tomorrow. I feel like I've completely got out of the swing of it, so we're gonna have to see how it goes. But that being said, it's so important that you take advantage of this time, because remember, as soon as your exams are finished, you're going to have a lovely summer filled with happy memories, and you're not going to have to worry about exams. But right now, this is the time for you to really put in everything that you've got and just push that final stretch and just see the light at the end of the tunnel. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a big thumbs up if you did enjoy. Comment down below any questions that you might have, and I will see you very soon with a new video. Bye guys. Mwah.